masterclasses on Giselle continue on BBC Two shortly. We on One join with listeners to Stereo Radio 2 for the moment of truth for singers and songwriters from 21 countries as we go live to Dublin to join Terry Wogan at the Eurovision Song Contest.
Good evening and welcome to Dublin, scene of the 33rd running of the Eurovision Song Contest. Who said it wouldn't last? Dublin in its millennium year, a fitting stage for this mighty song fest. This year, 21 nations from Iceland to Yugoslavia, locked in song. Now, very few countries can resist the God-given opportunity of a Eurovision with an audience worldwide in hundreds of millions to flaunt their scenic beauties, and as you can readily see, Ireland's no exception. This is the land of the four green fields, the Emerald Isle, the island of saints and scholars, of poets and writers, of prehistoric standing stones and Celtic crosses, of castles and monasteries, of mountains and lakes, rivers and glens, and everywhere, water. If it's not underfoot, it's fallen from the skies. Thank God we're surrounded by water. It's a great old Irish song.
Touch me the way you used to do. Oh, I know tonight could be all I have with you. From now on, you'll be with someone else instead of me. So tonight, let's fill this memory. Now for the last time, hold me now. Don't cry, don't say a word. Just hold me now, and I will know that we're apart. We'll always be together, forever. What do you say when words are not enough?
Dave, August Falcherov Illig, Gablaclia, Priv Kaharnahern.
This is the other presenter tonight, Pat Kenny, addressing you now in Gaelic. He'll be saying it all again in English in a minute, so I'll just tell you that this man has made his reputation here as a serious presenter, a political interviewer. If he does well tonight and Britain wins the contests, I can just see Sir Robin Day presenting it next year. Incidentally, the anti-post betting has installed Switzerland as the favourites, closely followed by Germany, the UK and Norway. And on the basis of what I've seen at rehearsal, the winner should come from these countries. Israel and Luxembourg look to be the best outsiders.
Thank you, Pat. Bonsoir. Et comment dit en Irlande, Cade Mille Falche, Cent Mille Bienvenue.
Michelle Rocker, as you can hear, speaks Gaelic as well as Italian, and as you can readily hear, French. This girl is as useful as a small pot.
Tous nos amis et collègues du monde de la télévision.
And it's especially appropriate that we welcome you to our capital city this year because Dublin is celebrating its 1,000th birthday. I've been talking to the Norwegians. I have to say they're much better behaved than their ancestors were of 1,000 years ago, who sailed up the River Liffey in their longboats. Oh. I can assure you they haven't pillaged a single monastery along the way. But who knows if they don't win, what'll happen tomorrow morning? Anyway, we've been preparing all week, and I think we're almost ready.
Indeed, our 21 entries are just getting ready to perform on the stage of this instant theatre created by RTE at the Simmons Court Pavilion of the Royal Dublin Society.
Now, believe it or not, we're actually nearing the moment where the contest will start. Well, as they've said, the old city on the Liffey's been entertaining its international visitors. When they set out to entertain you in Ireland, you stay entertained. Now, while your eyes feast on the revelry, we blind you with a few figures. This year, 21 countries taking part in 16 different languages. Never mind the Tower of Babel. 34 television services will be relaying the show, representing 30 countries, including, as you've heard, Australia. Any suggestions that this is a reprisal for Neighbours have been denied. That's the Lord Mayor and, of course, Johnny Logan again. This is not the Johnny Logan show. You're watching the Eurovision.
Lord Mayor, Ministers, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, may we present the 33rd Eurovision Song Contest.
The artists are Beethoven. The song is going to be called Socrates, and they thought it a good idea if they took the two fellas, Stefan Hilmarsson and Sverrir Stormskir, to Croke Park in Dublin for a National Hurling League final. Hurling is claimed by the Irish to be the fastest field game in the world. Players are all amateur, 15-a-side game, played with an ash hurley. Crowd here in the Simmons Court extension of the Royal Dublin Society, the cream of Dublin society, Irish society, gathered here tonight.
A terrific, warm Irish welcome for our first act. It's always very difficult to be first, and Iceland did very well. That was Beethoven, not Beethoven. Beethoven is probably rolling over just at the moment. Beethoven there, Stefan Hilmarsson and Sverrir Stormskir, and their song was called Socrates. Well, we're staying in Northern Europe, but moving slightly south to Sweden. Don't forget, Eurovision in 1974 was the launch pad for ABBA's worldwide success. So representing Sweden this year is Tommy Körberg, and he recently starred in the London West End musical Chess, which in a nice Eurovision coincidence was co-written by Benny and Bjorn of ABBA. The song, Stadilus, City of Light.
Tommy Körberg to sing for Sweden. After we've had a little promotional film here, it's the man himself being asked to join the pilot in the cockpit. It seemed like an amusing idea. The composer of this song, incidentally, is a lady called P. Beckman. And the pilot, of course, is Tommy's manager. And guess what he presents him with? I don't know who landed the plane.
Stadius i en land utan namn. sonar allt för en plats när tiden inte längre finns. Så ser jag oss tillsammans och då är resan slut, det enda som vi minns.
Gave that everything to Tommy Quarrivay. Fine singer. This was one of the pre-season favourites. And a bow from the conductor. Thank you, sir.
The conductor there was Anders Berglund, the Swedish song City of Light. Now, one of the nicest trips you can make by boat is from Stockholm to the archipelago of a thousand islands to Finland. And that's where we're going next. The Finnish entry is sung by the group Boulevard and the song Nauravat Silmat Mues Tetan. Laughing eyes are the ones you remember.
Hard to beat a chuckling eye, certainly. Pepe and Kirsty Vilberi have written this. The Irish are obsessed with cycling. It's a great life, a wheel. And the lads from Finland have joined in, as you can see. Why wouldn't people like cycling around here? The weather is lovely, and they have the two greatest cyclists in the world, Sean Kelly, and last year's winner, there he is, of the Tour de France, Stephen Roach.
We're moving next to our nearest neighbour, the United Kingdom. And in the past, UK entrants have done spectacular things on stage, like going barefoot, remember Sandy Shaw? And taking off their skirts midway through, remember Bucks Fizz? They do all sorts of things. Anyway, this year's representative has promised us that he's going to keep all his clothes on right throughout his entire song. His name is Scott Fitzgerald, he's from Glasgow in Scotland, and the song says simply, go.
And it's written by Julie Forsyth, the sainted Brucie's daughter. Brucie's here in the audience to cheer her on, and the song, of course. As all, we all will be, of course. They're in Bonratty Castle here, built in the 16th century. Stronghold of the O'Briens, Earls of Thomond and High Kings of Ireland. Restored to its original splendour, and entertains many a tourist. There's also a folk village here. And Scott has been made the Earl of Thomond for the night, being sung at and feasted with. And what he doesn't know is that when it all ends, he's thrown into a dungeon. So hope he gets back in time for the contest. That's a relief. This is it, the United Kingdom entry. Song number 4, Go.
Looking back on the times we had, things are beautiful then, but how quick they've changed. When you were in love with me, then so suddenly he came along. Time is meant to heal the pain I thought was gone. Seeing you again has made it carry on. Go before you break.
He's made many friends here this week. A charming fellow. Scott Fitzgerald for the United Kingdom, I would say, up there in the top five with that. Ronnie Hazelhurst in everybody's top ten. Crowd loved that. Big applause.
The conductor there was Ronnie Hazelhurst. The UK entry go from Scott Fitzgerald. We're going due east now, all the way over to Turkey for our next song. The group is called MFO, not a musical flying object, but a very talented trio. The initials MFO stand for their names, Mashar, Fuat and Uzkan. They represented Turkey before at the Eurovision Song Contest in Sweden in 1985. Let's see how they're going to do second time around with their song, which is called Sufi.
Well, next to Spain, and if we're looking for omens this year, we find one in the name of the group, La Década, the decade, because precisely two decades ago, in 1968, Spain won the contest, and then they went on to do it again in 1969. Can this happen in Dublin? Anyway, the song has an interesting title, La Chica Que Yo Quiero, made in Spain, or The Girl That I Love Will Be Made in Spain, and why not?
Why not? Indeed, well put. This man is a Bible of information. I don't know why I'm here at all. He's doing all the work. La Chica Que Yo Quiero. No, that's not... You're listening to some traditional Irish music. That's not the Spanish entry. This is the Temple Bar district of Dublin, which is Dublin's left bank, I suppose.
Rehearsing with us all week, there's one song which you would have heard more than others. That's Happy Birthday. It was Scott Fitzgerald's birthday on Thursday, and our next singer was 28 yesterday. Representing the Netherlands, his name is Gerhard Joling, and his song is entitled Shangri-La.
A little partial cheering before the boy starts. Gerhard Joling for Netherlands. Composer is Peter Devine of this song. He's having a... Ooh! Where have I seen this before? Day shopping in Dublin's fair city. Romantic fool. Just had an eye full of hat. This is the Parscourt Townhouse Shopping Centre. Young love reunited. For the Netherlands, then. Gerhard Joling. Shangri-La is the song.
Respire, the vino ti svantiva.
we are. Written by Peter Devine, as you can see. Gerard Bueling. That was song 7.
And our conductor there was Harry van Hoof. The Dutch entry, Shangri-La, from Gerard Joling. I've been taking advice from our next guest because she did this very job in 1979 when Israel hosted the song contest. She did an absolutely wonderful job then, but her primary talent is as a singer, and she's voted again and again as her country's top female vocalist. Her name is Yardena Arazi, and her song has a profound ring to it, Ben Adam, Son of Man.
Also translated as Only Human. Yardena Arazi has sung for Israel before. She was sixth in 1976. She started singing while doing her national service. The composers are Boris Dimitsain and Ehud Manor. This is the DART, what's called the DART. In Ireland, it's a rapid transit system. And apparently, a jazz band plays on it every morning for the tired businessmen. This is a jazz band called Jazz News. What a way to go to work. Very discreet, lads. Sing song here. Clive James didn't fool me for a minute with that disguise. I bet he didn't fool you either with the red beret and the beard and the melodeon. Come on, Clive. That's the Israeli entry. A very good outside chance that has, I'd say. What do I know?
The conductor there was Eldad Shrim. The Israeli entry, Ben Adam. Now, the very first country to host the Eurovision Song Contest in 1956, and I wasn't even born, was Switzerland. And in an extraordinary coincidence, they won their own competition. They almost won again a couple of years later in Norway. And this year's song has the same composer as that entry. The singer who was born in Canada is Céline Dion, and her song is called Ne partez pas sans moi.
Oui. It's a Swiss entry. This is the favorite, of course. Céline Dion, Crossing the Bog of Allen. It's a big bog in the Midlands. Peat, of course, is a very, or the turf, am I saying peat? Turf is a very big industry in Ireland. Heats Irish homes, generates electricity. Céline Dion comes from Montreal. The composer is Nella Martinetti and Attila Sereftuk. Steady girl. This is a terrific singer, this girl. It's a very good song. the favourites have a habit of not quite getting there in the Eurovision Song Contest. Don't Leave Without Me, it's called Ne Partez Pas Sans Moi.
Vous allez peut-être trouver de nouvelles musiques. Vous, donnez-moi ma chance. Je veux chanter moi aussi.
Switzerland, Céline Dion. Good performance. I like that at the Simmons Court extension. I like that a lot. He enjoyed it too. Good man.
And the conductor there was Attila Sereftug, and that was the Swiss entry, song number 9, Ne Partez Pas Sans Moi, from Céline Dion. Now we're going to come home for a few minutes to hear the Irish entrance, song number 10.
And as you may know, Ireland has won 3 times, Johnny Logan twice, and Dana won for Ireland in 1970. We always won with a solo singer. Tonight's entrants are trying to break with that particular tradition.
Jump the Gun is a 5-man band who've been on the circuit for a couple of years now, and they were in the process of cutting their very first album when they won the honour of representing their country in this year's contest, so the album has had to be put off for just a little while.
Their song, which was written by one of the band, is called Take 'Em Home.
I could see forever, forever down that long.
Expect the biggest roar of the night for the home team. Jump the Gun. Take Him Home, the Irish entry. Song number 10, we've got 11 more to go. That's the man conducting the orchestra. Famous figure in Irish music, Noel Keelan.
And And our conductor there was Noel Keelan. I think we'll take you all to West Germany this summer for the European Nations Championship. Great cheer there. Anyway, that was Jump the Gun, Take Him Home. Next to Germany, by coincidence, and what has always been one of the strongest contenders in the song contest. They've been very close on so many occasions, and they finally won it spectacularly in 1982. Remember Nicole in that year? As a matter of fact, she's back this year as a commentator with the German delegation. This year's entry is written by that same strong team of Ralph Siegel and Bernd Meininger. But I think we have a unique act on stage. I've consulted our Eurovision historian, and he tells me that this is the very first time we've had a mother and daughter team appearing. Young Maxie has been playing piano since she was about 9, she's now 13, and her mother, Chris Garten, has been in the music business all her working life. They're singing Lied für einen Freund, Song for a Friend.
Ah, this is nice. Maxie, Chris Garten, mother and daughter. Take a day off in the country. An Irish jaunting car. I know you have to tolerate the man's bowler hat, but it's fun. They're coming to the town of Maynooth in an area of rich farmland, and of course, Kildare. In an island of horses, Kildare is preeminent. Not bad in the cattle either. Moyglare Manor. An Irish country house. What'll they have? Fish. Delicious. They like it rare, do they? This is the German entry, regarded as a hot favorite by some. Song number 11.
Our artist tonight is not exactly Mozart or Strauss, but an equally multi-talented man, Wilfried Schoitz. I hope he doesn't mind me describing him as the grand old man of popular music in Austria, but he's actually done a lot more than that, hasn't he, Michelle?
Indeed he has. He's been in the theatre, television drama, even the movies. He's an accomplished dancer and producer, and he's co-written the song.
Not quite the lady we'd all recognize from the Louvre in Paris. A much more dangerous femme fatale, I should think. Wilfried sings of Lisa, Mona Lisa.
That man's jacket is going to be all out of shape if he doesn't keep his hands out of his pockets. Old Wilfried, from the description, seems to be an all-round entertainer. What does he do in his spare time? Backs the horses, from the look of it. They love a horse race here. And the crack. The crack. It's just the jokes and the laughter and the talk. They like to win money as well, of course.
Sie lügt, doch sie belügt mich nicht. Sie trägt ihr Leben im Gesicht und sie lebt.
nirgendwo ist sie so schwer zu sehen. Nirgendwo bin ich froh, manchmal ihre Träume zu verstehen. Lisa, Mona Lisa, Lisa.
Borrowed that suit off Jonathan Ross. Don't know where he got the earring, though. It's a big one, isn't it? Oh, understatement as always. How very nice.
The conductor there, Harald Neuwirth. The Austrian entry, Lisa Mona Lisa. Now, if at first you don't succeed, what do? You try again. Our next artists have represented their country twice before, so perhaps third time lucky. Now, Søren and Kirsten are among Denmark's best-known and most successful singers. But Kirsten has had a lot of other things on her mind lately because she's expecting her second child in just a few weeks' time. So if anything happens, I'm told that Pat can handle all emergencies.
Yes, lots of boiling water, I think, is the standard routine, but I don't think my talents quite extend that far. I hope I'm not called upon to do duty tonight. Is there a doctor in the house? Anyway, Michelle, what's the song called?
The song is called Cadose Viaise.
Who is wrong and who is right?
Well, now, there's the question. This is Howth, a few kilometres from Dublin city centre. I'm not terribly keen on Howth. I went fishing for mackerel there once and caught a hook in my finger. But enough of me. It's got wonderful amenities, yachting and sailing. And old Kirsten and Soren have taken it to their hearts. With nothing they like better than a game of hands, knees, booms a daisy, and some whelks. They do a very good smoked salmon in Ireland, you know, and that's the Irish wine. I wish they wouldn't do this because I haven't had any lunch. This is a killer, this. Wait till you see this crowd when they get on stage. This is the Danish entry, 13. And people ask me why I like doing the Eurovision Song Contest. Where else would you see something like that? For goodness sake, the people who traveled thousands of miles. Girls in tutus with cardboard guitars.
The conductor there was Henrik Jensen, and the Danes still up to a bit of pillaging these days. Kirsten and Soren, and who is wrong and who is right. Well, next we fly south to where the Aegean and the Mediterranean meet, the sunny climes of Greece, and a singer with an evocative name, Aphrodite Frida. The song, too, invokes a universal figure whose mask may equally conceal sorrow and joy. The song is entitled Clown.
we welcome back someone who came to Dublin as a backing singer for Norway in 1981. In fact, she's competed 5 times. Anita Skorgen. She is back this year as a composer. The song she has written is called For Vorjor, which they translated as Child of Earth. To sing it, an 18-year-old student who will accompany herself on piano, Caroline Kruger.
Erik Hilstad wrote this along with Anita Skorgen. And again, this is a well-regarded song. This will be one of the favorites. They took this young lady out to the Aran Islands off Galway. The wild and barren Aran Islands, where they say the original Irish are. In the Corrocks, a wooden frame covered in canvas and tar, which are still used to fish in the wild Atlantic. Going to be there as well in the final shake-up. That candelabra sits so incongruously among all the technology and the lasers and the huge screens that are such a feature of this year's presentation.
And the conductor there was Ariel Starr. That was Caroline Kruger and For Vorjor, Child of Earth. Next to Belgium, who were host to this competition last year, and they'd never won before until 1986, so can they do it so soon again? Well, the man with the task is Reinhardt, who, in spite of a penchant for serious issues in his writing, has given us a very lyrical title. Laissez briller le soleil, let the sun shine, or to give it its official title in English, the sun could shine in your heart.
The words are by Philippe Anciot, music by Joseph Reinhardt. This is Ryan's of Parkgate Street. He loves it. Started out as a street singer, this man, at the age of 18. He's at home here. Among the Creamy Pints and the Dubliners. Internationally famous group in their own right. I'd kill the fella who made that Irish coffee. Look at it. You can't have a khaki Irish coffee.
Ooh, wanna stick to something.
who was in even the conductor's cottage. Oh, he's not like that.
The conductor there, Daniel Willem. That was Reinhardt and Laissez Briller le Soleil. Now, how does the tiny duchy of Luxembourg do so well in the Eurovision Song Contest? They've won 5 times, so it's a lot to live up to. But our singer should be well up to the task. She's a multi-talented performer, having studied dance as well as music. Her name is Lara Fapian, and her song is called Croire, which in English they like to translate as trust.
That has a good chance. That's the Luxembourg entry. That'd be in my top 5.
Le chef d'orchestre, Régis Dupré, et la belle chanteuse, Lara Fabian, representing Luxembourg. Just 4 songs to go as we move next to Italy, another country which has produced more than its share of wonderful singers, wonderful voices, wonderful names. Representing Italy is Luca Barbarossa, who is one of the biggest stars in his country. His song is called Ti Scrivo, I'm Writing to You.
Luca Barbarossa, what a name, rings off the tongue. This is road bowling. You'll not see this in many places, not even in Ireland. It's a sort of Cork game. Particularly in County Cork, they do the road bowling. It's a 28-ounce, 1 kilo steel ball, hurled along the road by 2 players over an arranged distance, and of course, the least throws in the end wins the game. You can see it's quite difficult, particularly when you get into the rough. Scrivo, Italian entry in this year's Eurovision Song Contest. If you've just come in, coming to you from Dublin, the 33rd contest. You've missed a lot of good songs. Missed a lot of strange songs.
That was the Italian entry sung by Luca Barbarossa called Ti Scrivo. E l'Italia mi è cara perché ho sangue italiano. vorrei dire ciao ciao a mio fratello a Spilambergo e ai miei parenti a Fidenza e Colecchio. Tanti saluti da Dublino, dove la vita è meravigliosa. Arrivederci. È vero, Patrizio?
Sì, è vero, Michela. That was Michelle looking for a job on Italian television, for those of you who didn't understand.
Yes. We're selling the ice cream.
Anyway, from Italy, we're moving to their Mediterranean neighbor, France, another country with a good record of wins in the song contest. Well, tonight, France is represented by a man who is very well known throughout his country. His name is Gérard Lenormand. I'm told he's passionate, romantic, and if we're to believe the words of the song, very, very charming. It's called Chanteur de Charme.
It's another all-round entertainer, heavy with the charm. Gérard Lenormand. The composers are Claude Lemel and Gérard himself. Wrote his first song when he was 12. Then he was 15 when Brigitte Bardot sang one of his compositions. And he also waits at table on ferries. There's more sides to this man than you'd at first think. There's a little Coltus Kjoltori Aaron group there. There's a lot of music in Ireland, isn't there? Trainee Baron player, that's the little Irish skin drum that you play with a stick. It makes that drumming noise. Obviously. Made of goatskin. No, the Baron. Sunglasses. You don't see many of those in Ireland.
Besoin d'entendre des chansons tendres, des colliers, des mots qui dansent sur du papier. Besoin de croire toutes ces histoires de trois fois rien qui riment mal, qui font du bien. Rien n'a jamais empêché. Sentiments légers, rabâchés, romantiques, chanteurs de charme, c'est beau, c'est grand, c'est merveilleux, chanteurs de charme, chanteurs de charme.
It was a very enthusiastic reception for what I didn't think was a particularly outstanding song. He's a lived-in face. Oh, Gérard, hasn't he? Yes, the crowd loved it.
Le chef d'orchestre, Guy Mattioni. Gérard Lenormand, bien sûr, chanteur de charme. Next, we go to Portugal and our second last song. It's called Volterai, or I'll Return. And to sing it is someone who has already represented Portugal in Bergen in 1986, Dora.
Dora. We remember Dora from Bergen. Dora wore the boots. What she got on today? Well, she won't be singing that. That's an Irish outfit. The composers are José Calvario and José Nitza.
Well, we're almost there. The 21st of 21 songs comes next, and it comes from Yugoslavia. I must say my heart goes out to the Yugoslavian delegation. They've had to sit through every other act. It's difficult to be first, but I think it's equally difficult to come last, because they've nerves growing and growing all the time. But they've sent to Dublin their country's most famous rock band, Silver Wings, and they've been in their domestic charts since 1979. The song's entitled Mangoop or Rascal. We mentioned earlier in the program this was a week of birthdays. It certainly was. We had Scott Fitzgerald and Hira Joling. And Lydia Asanovic, the lead singer there, is going to celebrate her birthday in just 2 hours' time. So win, lose, or draw, she'll be having a party later on.
The minutiae of the Eurovision Song Contest.
There you have it. 21 songs from 21 countries. We've had over 100 artists here with us this week, over 100 artists on that stage. And those providing the backing, the string sounds, the good orchestral sounds, are sitting over there, led by Alan Smale, and under the baton of Noel Keelan, may we remind you of the presence of the RTE Concert Orchestra.
A well-deserved bow from them and from Noel Keelan, one of Ireland's most distinguished musicians. They've gone manfully tonight.
Well, the last song from Yugoslavia was the last song in the competition, but not the last song in our show. The music industry is a very important one, one that provides joy, but also jobs for many people. It's especially attractive to young people, reflecting as it does their energy, their talent, their integrity. Music is also a common language. Music knows no frontiers. So we've given the stage tonight to a young act and asked them to show us their Europe, a Europe post-1992, when most of the frontiers now dividing us will vanish. Over the next few minutes, our cameras take us from the tip to the toe of Europe. This video was produced with the assistance of the European Commission and has been shot throughout the community as well as in other European countries. So join us now as we move from Bergen in Norway through Odense, Amsterdam, Brussels, Paris, Heidelberg, Zurich, Lisbon, Valencia, all the way down to Taormina in Sicily, not forgetting a quick stop off in Dublin for a sandwich. To start us off on our journey, Liam Whaley, lead singer, with the Hot House Flowers. Thank you.
on Arigasha, he shows Christ to Amen. V. Litter City, Old Spadale, Fathers of V. Da, Tachter Riloga, is in Rina Tainiv. I wrote this song for a friend called Amen, who was in hospital while the spring was approaching. It's a song of celebration of spring and celebration of people.
Ladies and gentlemen, the hottest property in the business, the Hothouse Flowers.
That was the interval music provided by an up-and-coming Irish band, Hothouse Flowers. Boy.
And while the Hothouse Flowers were performing, the 21 international juries were collating their marks for our 21 competing songs.
Each competing country provides not only a singer, a song, and a conductor, but a jury as well, who award points to 20 other countries. Now, a jury is not allowed to vote for their own country's song. There are 336 jurors voting right throughout Europe, and they represent a cross-section of all ages and all walks of life, other than the music industry or broadcasting. And each has to vote for 10 countries and give their votes in ascending order, 1 point, 2 points, 3 points, and so on, right up to 8 points. Then you skip 9 points and award a 10 point, and then you go straight to the maximum, which is 12 points.
But before the tension gets too much for all of us, let's start the voting. And keeping a careful eye on the votes from all our juries is a man who has become synonymous with this great annual event. Representing the European Broadcasting Union, the Eurovision scrutineer for the contest, Mr. Frank Neff.
What would this contest be without old Frank?
Well, I think any of you who, like myself, have watched the Eurovision Song Contest over the years will recognize Frank's face. And this is a very important year for him. He is celebrating 10 years at the Eurovision Song Contest. This is sort of a happy birthday for him.
It is everybody's birthday. The world's birthday at the Eurovision Song Contest. I love the change of costumes and hairstyles.
Well, Frank, how does it feel? 10 years and a total of 11 different song contests.
Well, Pat, I feel great. And at the same time, I'm very happy to be in Dublin this time on this occasion, because really, with the millennium being celebrated, it's a great day for me. Thank you.
And is everything fine for the voting? Technically, all the lines and circuits through?
I hope so, but I think I crossed my fingers, and technically, everything is all right now.
Okay, crossing our fingers. And along with Frank, we have Marie-Claire Vionnet, and checking the figures for RTE is Sean Gibson. Now, the votes will be entered into our computer, and as all of you know here very well, nothing can go wrong with a computer. So I'm going to call up our scoreboard now, and with a flick of the switch, I reveal all. Our scoreboard comes to you from the bowels of the software of our computer, and this is the scoreboard. Our first votes tonight are from the Icelandic jury. Good evening, Reykjavik.
Good evening, Dublin. This is Reykjavik calling. Here are the results of the Icelandic jury. United Kingdom, 1 point.
United Kingdom, 1 point. Royaume-Uni, 1 point.
Spain, 2 points.
Spain, 2 points. España, 2 points.
Sweden, 3 points.
Sweden, 3 points. Suède, 3 points.
Luxembourg, 4 points.
Luxembourg, 4 points. Luxembourg, 4 points.
Norway, 5 points.
Norway, 5 points. Norvège, 5 points.
Israel, 6 points.
Israel, 6 points. Israel, 6 points.
Switzerland, 7 points.
Switzerland, 7 points. Suisse, 7 points.
Germany, 8 points.
Germany, 8 points. Allemagne, 8 points.
Denmark, 10 points.
Denmark, 10 points. Denmark, 10 points.
And finally, Yugoslavia, 12 points.
And finally, boy. Yugoslavia.
I must have been doing this thing for about 300 years, and the scoring never ceases to amaze me.
Yugoslavia, 12 points.
And that completes the
points. We hope the lines from the various other nations will be a bit better than the one from Iceland.
And thank you very much indeed, Reykjavik in Iceland, our first vote. And always, it's a tradition in the Eurovision Song Contest, the first country to get 12 votes gets a big round of applause. Okay, Michelle, where to next?
Well, our second country this evening is Sweden. Good evening, Malmö. May we have your votes, please?
Good evening, Dublin. Malmö calling. Here are the results of the Swedish jury. Iceland, 1 point.
Iceland, 1 point. Island, 1 point.
France, 2 points.
France, 2 points. France, 2 points.
Denmark, 3 points.
Denmark, 3 points. Danemark, 3 points.
Turkey, 4 points.
Turkey, 4 points. Turkey, 4 points.
United Kingdom, 5 points.
United Kingdom, 5 points. Royaume-Uni, 5 points.
Yugoslavia, 6 points.
Yugoslavia, 6 points. Yugoslavia, 6 points.
Ireland, 7 points.
Ireland. Ireland, 7 points. Irland, 7 points.
Norway, 8 points.
Norway, 8 points. Norvège, 8 points.
Luxembourg, 10 points.
Luxembourg, 10 points. Luxembourg, 10 points.
And Switzerland, 12 points.
And Switzerland, 12 points. Suisse, 12 points.
And that completes the points of the Swedish jury. Good night.
Good night, Sweden.
Well, good night, Malmö. We're not going too far from Sweden to our next jury. That's in Finland. Hello, Helsinki.
Hello, Dublin. Helsinki calling. Here are the votes of the Finnish jury. Yugoslavia, 1 point.
Yugoslavia, 1 point. Yugoslavia, 1 point.
Ireland, 2 points.
Ireland, 2 points. Irlande, 2 points.
France, 3 points.
France, 3 points. France, 3 points.
Denmark, 4 points.
Denmark, 4 points. Denmark, 4 points.
Switzerland, 5 points.
Switzerland, 5 points. Suisse, 5 points.
Israel, 6 points.
Israel, 6 points. Israel, 6 points.
Norway, 7 points.
Norway, 7 points. Norvège, 7 points.
Italy, 8 points.
Italy, 8 points. Italie, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
And Luxembourg, 12 points.
Luxembourg, 12 points. Luxembourg, 12 points.
And that completes the votes from Helsinki. Good night to you all.
Good night, Helsinki, and thank you very much.
Luxembourg, 2 points in the lead.
Is the jury from the United Kingdom. We go across the waters to our nearest neighbours. Good evening, London. May we have your votes?
Hello, Michelle, and good evening to you all in Dublin. BBC London calling. I have here the results of the United Kingdom jury. Turkey, 1 point.
Turkey, 1 point. Turkey, 1 point.
Sweden, 2 points.
Sweden, 2 points. Suède, 2 points.
Ireland, 3 points.
Ireland, 3 points. Irland, 3 points.
Israel, 4 points.
Israel, 4 points. Israel, 4 points.
Germany, 5 points.
Germany, 5 points. Allemagne, 5 points.
Netherlands, 6 points.
Netherlands, 6 points. Pays-Bas, 6 points.
Luxembourg, 7 points.
Luxembourg, 7 points. Luxembourg, 7 points.
Yugoslavia, 8 points.
Yugoslavia, 8 points. Yugoslavie, 8 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points. Suisse, 10 points.
And Norway, 12 points.
And Norway, 12 points. Norvège, 12 points.
And that completes the points of the United Kingdom jury. Good night to you.
Good night, London.
Thank you very much indeed, London. We're going now to the Turkish jury. Good evening, Ankara.
Good evening, Dublin. Ankara calling. Here are the results of the Turkish jury. Germany, 1 point.
Germany, 1 point. Allemagne, 1 point.
Ireland, 2 points.
Ireland, 2 points. Ireland, 2 points.
Greece, 3 points.
Greece, 3 points. Grèce, 3 points.
Italy, 4 points.
Italy, 4 points. Italy, 4 points.
Spain, 5 points.
Spain, 5 points. Espagne, 5 points.
Netherlands, 6 points.
Netherlands, 6 points. Pays-Bas, 6 points.
Yugoslavia, 7 points.
Yugoslavia, 7 points. Yugoslavie, 7 points.
France, 8 points.
France, 8 points. France, 8 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points. Suisse, 10 points.
Finally, United Kingdom, 12 points.
United Kingdom, 12 points. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
And that completes the points of the Turkish jury. Good night.
Good night, Ankara. Thank you very much indeed. All right, we've had 5 juries, so I think it's time for a quick review of what's going on to eliminate the crowded scoreboard down to the top 5. We see that Switzerland is in the lead with 44 points, Yugoslavia in second place with 34, just one behind is Luxembourg with 33, one behind again, Norway with 32, and not too far behind again, the United Kingdom in fifth place with 28 points.
That's good scoring
right,
for the United Kingdom.
Next, Michelle?
Next to sunny Spain. Good evening, Madrid. May we have your votes, please?
Apparently not. I must say it's surprising.
Good evening, Madrid.
So far, the voting for Yugoslavia, which I certainly didn't rate as a song, and it's there in second place with 34 points.
Madrid calling with the results of the Spanish jury.
Thank
you. We're through to Madrid.
Denmark, 1 point.
Denmark, 1 point. Denmark, 1 point.
France, 2 points.
France, 2 points.
Germany, 3 points.
Germany, 3 points. Allemagne, 3 points.
Portugal, 4 points.
Portugal, 4 points. Portugal, 4 points.
Turkey, 5 points.
Turkey, 5 points. Turkey, 5 points.
Israel, 6 points.
Israel, 6 points. Israel, 6 points.
Italy, 7 points.
Italy, 7 points. Italy, 7 points.
Switzerland, 8 points.
Switzerland, 8 points. Suisse, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Le Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
And Ireland, 12 points.
Well, that's bound to be popular in the hall. The United Kingdom doing very well in this early stage of the scoring. And that's the Irish team, of course. And Switzerland still in the lead with 52 points.
A very partisan crowd we have here, I think, Michelle, tonight. Anyway, we're going to go on to the Dutch jury now. We're going to the Netherlands. Good evening, Hilversum.
Good evening, Dublin.
May we have your votes, please?
Yes, here are the results of the Dutch jury. Turkey, 1 point.
Turkey, 1 point. Turkey, 1 point.
France, 2 points.
France, 2 points. France, 2 points.
Israel, 3 points.
Israel, 3 points. Israel, 3 points.
Iceland, 4 points.
Iceland, 4 points. Island, 4 points.
Luxembourg, 5 points.
Luxembourg, 5 points. Luxembourg, 5 points.
Ireland, 6 points.
Ireland, 6 points. Irlande, 6 points.
Norway, 7 points.
Norway, 7 points. Norvège, 7 points.
Sweden, 8 points.
Sweden, 8 points. Suède, 8 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points. Suisse, 10 points.
Denmark, 12 points.
Denmark, 12 points.
Do you remember Denmark, the Danish entry?
12 points.
And that completes the points of the jury of the
Switzerland still in the lead with 62.
And thank you very much, Hilversum.
And Norway in second place.
Next we go to Israel. Good evening, Jerusalem. May we have your votes, please?
Hello, Dublin. Hello, Michelle. Good evening, Jerusalem calling. Here are the results of the Israeli jury. Norway, 1 point.
Norway, 1 point. Norvège, 1 point.
Spain, 2 points.
Spain, 2 points. Espagne, 2 points.
Finland, 3 points.
Finland, 3 points.
That's welcome for Finland. No points so far. No points for Austria and Belgium yet.
Excuse me, could you just hold on for 1 moment, please? Finland, 3 points. Another next
question. Germany, 5 points.
Germany, 5 points. Allemagne, 5 points.
No, please.
Denmark,
please, sorry, don't go on. To which are you giving 4 points, please?
Could you repeat the country you're giving 4 points to, please?
Netherlands, 7 points.
Hello, Jerusalem. Could we go back to the fourth, to whom you're giving 4 points to, please?
4 points to Switzerland.
Thank you. Switzerland, 4 points. Suisse, 4 points. And now we'll continue with the fifth, etc. Okay?
Germany, 5 points.
Thank you. Germany, 5 points. Allemagne, 5 points.
Denmark, 6 points.
Denmark, 6 points. Danemark, 6 points.
Netherlands, 7 points.
Netherlands, 7 points. Pays-Bas, 7 points.
Turkey, 8 points.
Turkey, 8 points. Turkey, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
And Yugoslavia, 12 points.
Yugoslavia, 12 points.
Oh, Yugoslavia,
12 points.
And that completes the points given by the Israeli jury, Jerusalem. Good night, Dublin.
Good night and thank you.
We shall probably get an update.
All right, I think it's time to have a look at our scoreboard. A lot of heavy scoring for several countries and one or two, notably Austria and Belgium, yet to score. So let's have a look at that scoreboard and we'll get our computer to order it for us and tell us who is in the lead at the moment. The numbers are just filling in and if you look closely, we're waiting for a number one to pop up and it's just done so beside Switzerland. So Switzerland are in the lead at the moment and in second place is the United Kingdom. In third place, we're looking at Yugoslavia with 46 points. In fourth place, Norway with 40. And as I say, Belgium and Austria still to score. Where's Ireland in all of this? Well, Ireland is standing in seventh place at the moment, just for those in the audience who don't have their pocket computers with them. Right, it's time to go to our next jury. We're going to the Swiss jury. Bonsoir, Bern.
Bonsoir, Dublin. Ici Berne. Voici les résultats du jury suisse. Danemark, 1 point.
Danemark, 1 point. Denmark, 1 point.
Yougoslavie, 2 points.
Yougoslavie, 2 points. Yugoslavia, 2 points.
France, 3 points.
France, 3 points. France, 3 points.
Irlande, 4 points.
Irlande, 4 points. Ireland, 4 points.
Royaume-Uni, 5 points.
Royaume-Uni, 5 points. The United Kingdom, 5 points.
Espagne, 6 points.
Espagne, 6 points. Spain, 6 points.
Pays-Bas, 7 points.
Pays-Bas, 7 points. The Netherlands, 7 points.
Italy, 8 points.
Italy, 8 points. Italy, 8 points.
Israel, 10 points.
Israel, 10 points. Israel, 10 points.
Et pour le Luxembourg, 12 points.
Luxembourg, 12 points. Luxembourg, 12 points.
That pretty girl looks pleased. And so she should. In third place, Luxembourg now at 50 points. UK in second place with 53. Switzerland still in the lead at 66.
Bolaert a Hjoin, can I have the Irish vote, Ledahull?
Yes, Margaret Michel, Dublin calling. Here are the results of the Irish jury.
Thank you.
Israel, 1 point.
Israel, 1 point. Israel, 1 point.
Netherlands, 2 points.
Netherlands, 2 points. Les Pays-Bas, 2 points.
Yugoslavia, 3 points.
Yugoslavia, 3 points. Yugoslavie, 3 points.
Denmark, 4 points.
Denmark, 4 points. Danemark, 4 points.
Sweden, 5 points.
Sweden, 5 points. Suède, 5 points.
Germany, 6 points.
Germany, 6 points. Allemagne, 6 points.
United Kingdom, 7 points.
United Kingdom, 7 points. Le Royaume-Uni, 7 points.
Norway, 8 points.
Norway, 8 points. Norvège, 8 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points. Suisse, 10 points.
And Luxembourg, 12 points.
Luxembourg, 12 points. Luxembourg, 12 points.
Yes, that's Lara Fabienne, who's coming up on the rails with 62 points.
That's the first time in my life I've heard John Skeehan referred to as Sean. Anyway, thanks very much to the Irish jury, not too far down the road from where we are here at the Simmons Court in the RDS in Dublin. Time to look at the top five again. And if you look at the scoreboard, it tells us that Switzerland are leading with 76 points. In second place is Luxembourg with 62. The United Kingdom, a very close third with 60 points. Yugoslavia next with 51 points. And Norway in fifth place with 48 points. We're now going to hear from the German jury. Good evening, Munich.
Good evening, Dublin. Munich calling. Hello, Pat, Michelle. Hello. And happy birthday, Dublin.
Thank you very much indeed. I'm happy to tell you we don't feel our age. We don't feel 1,000 years old. And perhaps after this is over, we will. Can you give us your votes, please?
Here are the results of the German jury. Norway, 1 point.
Norway, 1 point. Norvège, 1 point.
Italy, 2 points.
Italy, 2 points. Italie, 2 points.
France, 3 points.
France, 3 points. France, 3 points.
Denmark, 4 points.
Denmark, 4 points. Danemark, 4 points.
Israel, 5 points.
Israel, 5 points. Israel, 5 points.
Netherlands, 6 points.
Netherlands, 6 points. Pays-Bas, 6 points.
And Ireland, 7 points.
Ireland, 7 points. Irlande, 7 points.
Turkey, 8 points.
Turkey, 8 points. Turkey, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
And last, but by no means least, Switzerland, 12 points.
Switzerland's with the favourite before the contest started.
Swiss.
And it's Céline Dion, you can see in the centre of that picture.
And that completes the points of the German jury.
Switzerland, 88. United Kingdom, their latest or nearest challengers with 70 points.
Thank you very much indeed, Munich, and a very good night to everybody in Germany. Right, where to next?
Next to Austria. Good evening, Vienna. May we have your votes, please?
Hello, Dublin. Vienna calling. Here are the results of the Austrian jury. Luxembourg, 1 point.
Luxembourg, 1 point. Luxembourg, 1 point.
Israel, 2 points.
Israel, 2 points. Israel, 2 points.
Norway, 3 points.
Norway, 3 points. Norvège, 3 points.
Yugoslavia, 4 points.
Yugoslavia, 4 points. Yugoslavie, 4 points.
Italy, 5 points.
Italy, 5 points. Italy, 5 points.
Ireland, 6 points.
Ireland, 6 points. Irlande, 6 points.
France, 7 points.
France, 7 points.
Spain, 8 points.
Spain, 8 points. Espagne, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
And Denmark, 12 points.
And Denmark, 12
well, that
points.
Puts the cat among the
Denmark,
pigeons.
Douze
surprise,
points.
Top marks for Denmark there from Austria. And it means the United Kingdom is within 8 points of the leader, Switzerland.
A very good night to you in Vienna. Well, with Denmark getting 12 points there, it seems very appropriate that we should be going to talk to the Danish jury now. Good evening, Copenhagen.
Good afternoon, Dublin. Good evening, Dublin. Copenhagen calling. Here are the results of the Danish jury. Spain, 1 point.
Spain, 1 point. España, 1 point.
Luxembourg, 2 points.
Luxembourg, 2 points. Luxembourg, 2 points.
France, 3 points.
France, 3 points. France, 3 points.
Iceland, 4 points.
Iceland, 4 points. Island, 4 points.
Norway, 5 points.
Norway, 5 points. Norvège, 5 points.
Germany, 6 points.
Germany, 6 points. Allemagne, 6 points.
Ireland, 7 points.
Ireland, 7 points. Irlande, 7 points.
Sweden, 8 points.
Sweden, 8 points. Suède, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
That puts us in the lead.
Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
Let's see where the top goes.
Yugoslavia.
Yugoslavia. That means the United Kingdom's in the lead by 2 points. It's Lydia Asanovic.
And that completes the points of the Danish jury. Happy
well,
birthday
hail to
everybody.
Denmark. United Kingdom,
thank
2 points in the lead over Switzerland.
All in Denmark. Thank you, Copenhagen.
It's changed
all right,
radically.
We're past the halfway stage now, and as you can hear from the various squeals of delight in our audience, that certain people are doing well, certain people not so well, but I think it's time to review the scoreboard. We'll get our computer to order them now in order of achievement so far. Let's have a look at that scoreboard. And moving it towards us and putting in the ranking orders, and waiting for all the numbers to fill in. And with 90 points, I think the United Kingdom is going to earn that number one spot, with Switzerland in second place at 88 points. In third place is Yugoslavia, some way behind, 67 points. In fourth place is Luxembourg at 65. Fifth place is Norway with 57. And also in joint fifth place is Denmark on 57. and Austria and Belgium yet to score. So still some work to be done there to get them onto the scoreboard. Okay, where to next?
Now we hear from our Greek jury. Good evening, Athens. May we have your vote, please?
Καλησπέρα από την Αθήνα. Good evening, Dublin. This is Athens calling. Here are the results of the Greek jury. Portugal, 1 point.
Portugal, 1 point. Portugal, 1 point.
Luxembourg, 2 points.
Luxembourg, 2 points. Luxembourg, 2 points.
Israel, 3 points.
Israel, 3 points. Israel, 3 points.
Yugoslavia, 4 points.
Yugoslavia, 4 points. Yugoslavia, 4 points.
France, 5 points.
France, 5 points. France, 5 points.
United Kingdom, 6 points.
United Kingdom, 6 points. Royaume-Uni, 6 points.
Norway, 7 points.
Norway, 7 points. Norvège, 7 points.
Spain, 8 points.
Spain, 8 points. Espagne, 8 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
That puts the Swiss back in
Suisse,
the lead.
10 points.
Who's going to get the top mark?
Netherlands, 12 points.
Netherlands, 12 points. Pays-Bas, 12 points.
And that completes the points of the Greek jury.
Well,
thank
the lead is changing with every vote between the United Kingdom and Switzerland.
Thank you very much to the Greek jury. We're going now to Norway and to Oslo. Good evening, Oslo.
Good evening, Dublin. Oslo calling. And here are the votes of the Norwegian jury. France, 1 point.
France, 1 point. France,
Spain,
1 point.
Spain, 2 points.
Spain, 2 points. Espagne, 2 points.
Italy, 3 points.
Italy, 3 points. Italie, 3 points.
Germany, 4 points.
Germany, 4 points. Allemagne, 4 points.
United Kingdom, 5 points.
United Kingdom, 5 points. Royaume-Uni, 5 points.
Luxembourg, 6 points.
Luxembourg, 6 points. Luxembourg, 6 points.
Ireland, 7 points.
Ireland, 7 points. Irlande, 7 points.
Switzerland, 8 points.
Switzerland, 8 points. Suisse, 8 points.
Denmark, 10 points.
Denmark, 10 points. Danemark, 10 points.
And finally, Sweden, 12 points.
And finally,
Norway votes for Sweden.
12 points. Sweden, 12 points.
Tommy Hureberi, quite pleased about that. Switzerland just extending their lead slightly over the United Kingdom by 5 points. Still, anybody's game.
Nice to you, Oslo, and you are to be commended by the Swedes for your neighborly gesture.
Steady.
Right, thank you very much indeed, Norway. And where to next?
Et maintenant, nous allons appeler le prochain jury, qui est le jury belge. Goedenavond, België. Bonsoir, la Belgique. Puis-je avoir le résultat de votre jury?
Bonsoir, Dublin. Ici Bruxelles. Voici les résultats du jury belge.
Merci.
Suède, 1 point.
Suède, 1 point. Sweden, 1 point.
France, 2 points.
France, 2 points. France, 2 points.
Norvège, 3 points.
Norvège, 3 points. Norway, 3 points.
La Suisse, 4 points.
Suisse, 4 points. Switzerland, 4 points.
Irlande, 5 points.
Irlande, 5 points. Ireland, 5 points.
Espagne, 6 points.
Espagne, 6 points. Spain, 6 points.
Danemark, 7 points.
Danemark, 7 points. Denmark, 7 points.
Luxembourg, 8 points.
Luxembourg, 8 points. Luxembourg, 8 points.
Israël, 6 points.
Israël, 10 points. Israël, 10 points.
Et Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
And 12 points for Royaume-Uni puts us in the lead again. It's Julie Forsyth's Scott Fitzgerald, 113 points, 3 points in the lead. This is the closest finish for many a year on the Eurovision Song Contest.
Le jury prochain, c'est le jury luxembourgeois. Bonsoir, Luxembourg.
Bonsoir, Michel. Bonsoir, Pat. Et happy birthday, Dublin.
Ah, merci bien.
Voici les votes du jury luxembourgeois. Suisse, 1 point.
Suisse, 1 point. Switzerland.
How is that going to affect the vote? Just 1 point for Switzerland.
Italie, 2 points.
Italie, 2 points. Italy, 2 points.
Suède, 3 points.
Suède, 3 points. Sweden, 3 points.
Turquie, 4 points.
Turquie, 4 points. Turkey, 4 points.
Israël, 5 points.
Israël, 5 points. Israel, 5 points.
Espagne, 6 points.
Espagne, 6 points. Spain, 6 points.
Yougoslavie, 7 points.
Yougoslavie, 7 points. Yugoslavia, 7 points.
Royaume-Uni, 8 points.
Royaume-Uni, 8 points. The United Kingdom, 8 points.
France, 10 points.
France, 10 points. France, 10 points.
Pays-Bas, 12 points.
Pays-Bas, 12 points. The Netherlands
get the top mark
points.
From Luxembourg. And the United Kingdom is 10 points in the lead.
Bonsoir, Dublin.
Bonsoir, Luxembourg. All right, I think at this stage we should have a look at the top five again to see how things are panning out. And very close, as you can see.
Well, that's
in first
terrific.
Place, the United Kingdom with 100.
I must say, I expected us to be in the top five, but not topping it at this stage with only about 4 or 5 more votes to go.
To third place, Luxembourg on 81, 30 points behind. In fourth place, 3 behind Luxembourg is Yugoslavia on 78. And then Denmark in fifth place with 74.
It must be a two-horse race now. It's between the United Kingdom and Switzerland.
Race, but who knows what can happen over the next...
Scott Fitzgerald must be feeling very excited. Julie Forsyth.
Very calm and relaxed.
Ronnie Hazelhurst taking it cheerily.
Which himself and author Julie Forsyth must be feeling at this stage. All right, the next one.
Et maintenant, nous appelons le jury italien. Buonasera, Roma. Puis-je avoir le résultat du jury italien?
Allô, Dublin, ici Rome, voici les résultats du jury italien. Islande, 1 point.
Islande, 1 point. Iceland, 1 point.
Luxembourg, 2 points.
Luxembourg, 2 points. Luxembourg, 2 points.
Israël, 3 points.
Israël, 3 points. Israel, 3 points.
Norvège, 4 points.
Norvège, 4 points. Norway, 4 points.
Pays-Bas, 5 points.
Pays-Bas, 5 points. Netherlands, 5 points.
Yugoslavia, 6 points.
Yugoslavia, 6 points. Yugoslavia, 6 points.
Swiss, 7 points.
Suisse, 7 points. Switzerland, 7 points.
Espagne, 8 points.
Espagne, 8 points. Spain, 8 points.
Suède, 10 points.
Suède, 10 points. Sweden, 10 points.
Are Italy going to give United Kingdom? They are. 12 points to the United Kingdom.
12 points. United Kingdom.
It's beginning to look good for Scott Fitzgerald, Julie Forsyth, Jimmy Moore, head of Light Entertainment. Quite pleased. United Kingdom, 133 points. 118 to Switzerland. United Kingdom stretching its lead now.
Et maintenant, le jury français, bonsoir Paris.
Bonsoir Dublin, ici Paris. Voici les résultats du jury français. Suisse, 1 point.
Suisse, 1 point. Switzerland, 1 point.
Islande, 2 points.
Islande. C'est Islande. Oui.
Islande.
Islande, yes, 2 points. Iceland, 2 points.
Yougoslavie, 3 points.
Yougoslavie, 3 points. Yugoslavia, 3 points.
Irlande, 4 points.
Irlande, 4 points. Ireland, 4 points.
Belgique, 5 points.
Belgique, 5 points. Belgium, 5 points.
About time, too. The first points for Belgium. Poor old Austria.
Turkey, 6 points.
points.
Turkey, 6 points. Turkey, 6 points.
Grèce, 7 points.
Greece, 7 points.
Italy, 8 points.
Italy, 8 points.
Israël, 10 points.
Israël, 10 points. Israel, 10 points.
Danemark, 12 points.
Denmark, 12 points.
Well, that hasn't changed anything.
Except
it has put Yugoslavia is in third place, and Denmark in fourth place, and the United Kingdom still in the lead.
Five again, and see how things are shaping out.
Let's have a quick look, Pat.
Competition at this stage, and we see the United Kingdom, 133 points. In second place, Switzerland, 119, just 14 points behind. Yugoslavia, 87 points.
Yugoslavia have been the surprise packet of the whole thing. I wouldn't believe they get this many marks.
And Denmark. To go. So as you can see, with the maximum vote possible.
Yes, get the nails right. You're going to take the award.
24, and a minimum.
This must be nerve-wracking.
Pair of zero from the next two juries. It is still all to play for between those two countries.
Right down to the line, this is going. Only two more countries to vote.
It's getting very exciting, Pat, isn't it?
Well, yes, it is actually.
He's
I've been
controlling himself
all
well.
Yeah. Well, we, as Pat said, we go to our second last jury, which is the Portuguese jury. Good evening, Lisbon. May we have your votes, please?
And good evening to you, Dublin. This is Lisbon calling, and here are the results of the Portuguese jury.
Thank you.
France, 1 point.
France, 1 point.
Germany, 2 points.
L'Allemagne, 2 points.
United Kingdom, 3 points.
Ooh, that's
three
a low
points.
Score from Portugal for the United Kingdom.
3 points.
Luxembourg, 4 points.
Luxembourg, 4 points.
Ireland, 5 points.
Irlande, 5 points.
Denmark, 6 points.
Denmark, 6 points.
Norway, 7 points.
Norway, 7 points. Norvège, 7 points.
Iceland, 8 points.
Iceland, 8 points. Islande, 8 points.
Israel, 10 points.
Israel,
who's going to get the top
points.
Mark from Portugal?
Israel,
if they give it to Switzerland, it's right point. Down to the wire.
And Switzerland.
They have.
Switzerland, 12 points. La Suisse,
Céline Dion.
This completes
unbearable
the
tension. There's only 5 points
good
in it. United Kingdom's in the
Dublin.
Lead. And it's all down to Yugoslavia.
Well, I have to tell you that we employed Agatha Christie to write the script for tonight. We have a very close situation. I'm not sure if we can have a quick look at the top five again, but there's 5 points in it, I can tell you, between the United Kingdom and Switzerland. So can Scott Fitzgerald hang on by the skin of his teeth, or will Céline Dion catch up? She's only got to make up 5, so it's all to play for. Everything depends on Yugoslavia, and we're going now to Ljubljana to get the final vote this evening. Good evening, Yugoslavia. Good evening, Ljubljana.
Good evening, Dublin. Ljubljana calling. Here are the results of the Yugoslav jury. Israel, 1 point.
Israel, 1 point.
Ireland, 2 points.
Irlande, 2 points.
Luxembourg, 3 points.
Luxembourg, 3 points. Luxembourg, 3 points.
Spain, 4 points.
Spain, 4 points. Espagne, 4 points.
Italy, 5 points.
Italy, 5 points. Italy, 5 points.
Switzerland, 6 points.
Oh. Switzerland, 6 points.
Well, it puts Switzerland 1 point in the lead, so it depends.
Netherlands, 7 points.
Netherlands, 7 points. Pays-Bas, 7 points.
We've got to get...
Germany, 8 points.
Germany, 8 points. Almania...
We've got to get the 10 of the 12 to win it.
Norway, 10 points.
10 points Norway, to Norway. Who's getting the 12?
10 points. Norvège, 10
points. What a cliffhanger.
And finally, France.
Oh, goodness.
Finally.
What? Kipped at the post by Yugoslavia. Well, no, by Switzerland. They've won by 1 point. We didn't hear. I didn't catch who that last 12 points went to. We think it's France. France took the 12 points and just pipped the United Kingdom in the closest finish I've ever seen at the Eurovision Song Contest. Pipped them by 1 point. There's the winner, Switzerland's Céline Dion. It's hard to believe. Hard to believe when Switzerland only got 6 points from Yugoslavia that the United Kingdom weren't going to get something better and carry off the prize.
For the sake of the legality of the thing, complete the count with the Ljubljana jury. So can we have your final vote? 12 points for whom?
France, 12 points.
France, 12 points.
That's as we caught 12 points to France. And Switzerland have won by 1 point, one heartbreaking point.
And that completes the points of the Yugoslav jury.
Over Scott Fitzgerald and the Julie Forsyth composition goal.
Thank you very much indeed, Ljubljana, and a very good night.
That is a real heartbreaker.
Well, I just want to call up the top five again.
Is the tear-stained winner.
And you see how close it was.
Céline Dion.
We're just looking at the top five
comes
now.
Comes from Montreal in Canada. You can see it hasn't been that close
Kingdom, just one
in my experience ever.
136. What a finish.
Only two runners with about five or six countries to vote. And it was anybody's right up to the end. The United Kingdom leading in the last three sessions of voting and then gets pipped cruelly at the post by 1 point by this girl. I did say at the beginning I thought was the best singer in the contest. The song was the best song, I think. And the favourite, the anti-post favourite, Switzerland have won. Ne partez pas sans moi, written by Nella Martinetti and Attila Serevtuk, who also conducted the orchestra. That's Lara Fabian of Luxembourg, who did very well. Kisses all round, Johnny Logan, who's going to present the award.
Artist Ford. This is Céline Dion, as you may remember. A wonderful chanteuse. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And Miss Nella Martinetti.
Oh, thank you very much.
This is our composer, Nella Martinetti.
Nella Martinetti. And Attila
Serevtuk. Who wrote the music?
Congratulations to them. Commiserations, of course.
Johnny Logan, last year's winner.
To the United Kingdom entry.
To our winning
Scott
team,
Fitzgerald, who did so well.
And singer Céline Dion.
Who came up on the rails and looked as if he was going to win it and was pipped by 1 point at the very end by the winning song sung by this girl.
I bet, man.
I think a popular one for a good singer and a good song.
Well, as is customary on these occasions, we get to hear one song twice, and that is the winning song. So we're going to ask Céline to sing this again. Oh, we've got some more things which we want to present. Johnny, for all the artists, they each get a memento of the Millennium Eurovision Song Contest in Dublin, and a very beautiful thing it is too. So may I present?
Thank you
with
very much.
These?
Thank you.
From all of us here in Dublin, O gachéin yon seo imláchlia, Iowa, agus slán liv.
Bye-bye.
Now, thanks to Pat and Michelle, two charming presenters, to RTE, who did such a splendid job of staging this contest, and probably the most thrilling contest in the history, the 33-year-old history of the Eurovision, the winning song for Switzerland from Céline Dion, Ne partez pas sans moi. Congratulations to her.
Vous qui cherchez l'étoile, vous qui vivez sans rêve, vous héros de l'espace, au cœur plus grand que la terre, vous donnez-moi ma chance. Emmène-moi loin d'ici. Ne partez pas sans moi. Laissez-moi vous suivre. Vous qui volez vers d'autres vies, laissez-moi vivre. La plus belle aventure, le plus beau voyage qui mène un jour sur mer. Vous allez peut-être trouver de nouvelles.